Let me come to the next part. Who are the founders of Hinduism? Now, many books written by Westerners, they will say, Hinduism has no founders. Now, this is utter nonsense. This religion didn't come out of the sky and fallen overhead. So who are the founders? It's not that we don't have one founder. We have too many founders to count. This is, we are spoiled for choice. Every century produces some super giant who can talk about spirituality, religion from first and experience. So we are spoiled for choice. We don't have no founder. We have too many to count. This is the uniqueness of this tradition. But the reason why we use the Sanskrit term called apurusheya, this really apurusheya, doesn't mean no founder. It simply means it's a principle-oriented religion and not founded or if you like, you know, linked up with just one personality. So if you love Krishna, you don't say, oh, it's founded by Krishna. It's a principle-oriented religion. It says, really, you should not be focusing on the personality, but the principles he's talking about, the principles of Dharma. So it's a principle-oriented, that's why it's called apurusheya. It means not fixated on any individual personality, ancient or modern. Very open. So you can become the founders of Hinduism in modern times. You don't need to focus on ancient ones. It's open system. So if you like, this is the word. It doesn't have one founder. It has too many founders to count. There's one generic term the Hindus are given to their founders, or the people with authority of Hinduism. It's a very important word, authority. The word is Rishi. The term Rishi is derived from the Sanskrit root Drish. Drish means to encounter, to see firsthand. So the Hindus say the enterprise we call Dharma actually comes about because there are certain individuals who say, what is the underpinning of this reality? It's not something that we believe in or we try to trust or we just intellectualize, we actually experience. What is the underpinning of this reality? We come face to face with it. These are very special individuals. And the term Hindus use is Rishi. These are the founders of Hinduism, ancient and modern. And these are dramatic personalities. So the word is Rishi from the term Drish, first an encounter. And again, I would warn the Hindus, please be aware. Hinduism, because an open system, is open to abuse. And there are lots of others who like to gang up and say, call themselves Rishi. Rishi is not a minor term. There are very few people who can say, first and I know what I'm talking about. Not read it in a book. Or not just sat down in a coffee and discussed it. I know. These are very special individuals. And they are the founders or the people of, if you like, authority in the Hindu tradition. Please remember this. Don't be gullible and be taken for a ride. There may be very good storytellers, kathakars. They're glorified storytellers, but they are not rishis. There may be people who are highly intellectual, pandits, you know, very clever clocks. But they're just that. They're not rishis. When they talk from authority, the really powerful material comes out of their mouth, out of their lips. Very powerful personalities. These are the founders, ancient and modern. So again, no founder, no, too many founders to count.